Iowa is set to go with the WBC Continental Americas and NABO Cruiserweight Championship fight between Jarmel Barnes, who hails from Rochester, New York, and Ramon Garbay, who's from right here in Fort Lauderdale, Florida area. Well, this is an interesting case, David.
Well, Jarmel Barnes basically has two opportunities to win one fight. If he loses to Garbay, the NABO title is vacant, and Garbay cannot win it. Now, Barnes, if he would lose, would get the first shot at the next one. As you look at Garbay going in, he was 206 pounds, and the contract weight was 200. So Garbay cannot win in any case. If he wins, the title is vacant. If Barnes wins, the titles are his.
All right, so that's the situation. Garbay comes in. He had a tremendous amateur career in Cuba. 387 fights before coming to the United States in 1996. But he's been off for a couple of years with management problems. He was supposed to fight a month ago here at Warriors Boxing. And Gary Lane was a scheduled fight, but that never happened. And here comes Jarmel Barnes. He comes in 16-3. He's a school teacher from Rochester, New York. This is a nice kid. Very bright kid, graduated from Shaw University in Raleigh, North Carolina. And we got a highlight of Barnes in his last show, David. Let's take a look at it.
He came off a career-best victory against Robert Daniels. Now, Jarmel Barnes came down here unheralded, talking about the fact he was at 85% stamina level, thought that could be enough for him to win the fight, and he came up with a great performance here against the former champion. And Jarmel Barnes with the biggest win in his career, and he knew it. He's pounding his fist. Everything went well for him, and that was a must-have victory. And he got it in his last fight. Now he tries to parlay it. It says he's at 95%.
Well, at 95%, he should be pretty good. We're set to go to get this fight underway.
ABC
so let's
rules,
go
our
ring announcer, Damian Pinto.
ABC rules, I want a clean fight.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next fight, 12 rounds for the NABO Cruiserweight and the WBC Continental Americas Championship. Before we meet our principals, first introducing the man in charge of the action, when the bell rings, referee Jorge Alonso. Your supervisors of the NABO, Ricardo Rizzo, and supervisor for the WBC, Bismarck Morales. All right, my fans, here we go. 12 rounds for the championship, and here are your combatants. First, fighting into the corner to my right, hailing from Miami, Florida, and weighing at 206 pounds. He has a professional record of 16 victories, with only 3 defeats, 13 of those victories coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, he fights tonight from the blue corner, introducing Ramon Garbay. His opponent stands opposite in the corner to my left. He hails from Rochester, New York, and weighing in at 199 pounds. Ladies and gentlemen, he takes a 16-3, 3-loss record into the ring this evening. 4 victories coming by way of knockout. He hails from Rochester. Here he is, fighting from the red corner, Jarmel the Truth Barnes. Once again, here's your referee, Jorge Alonso. Last minute instructions for the NABO Cruiserweight and WBC Continental Americas Championship.
Got it ready.
You received instructions of the weigh-in yesterday. Entonces te la dieron en el pesaje ayer, okay? You want a clean fight, wash your fouls, wash your holding, don't punch behind your head. Quiero una pelea limpia, Garbay, okay? No quiero que me aguanten y me peguen en la nuca. Punch him up.
Once again, this fight is sanctioned by the Florida State Athletic Commission, the WBC, and the NABO. We'll take a look at the tail of the tape.
Barnes is 4 years younger. You see Garbay was over the weight limit, has a 3-inch reach advantage, and that could be a prominent weapon for him. Remember, he's been off for a while, too.
10-point must scoring system, no standing 8-count. In this fight, there is no 3-knockdown rule, as there is in the state of Florida because of it being an NABO and a WBC Continental American Championship fight here in the Cruiserweight division. Cruiserweight now, remember, was up to 200 pounds. Barnes, we saw him fight a month ago, did a nice job. He's supposed to be more of a boxer, but he was very aggressive in his fight against Robert Daniels and had a terrific win over Daniels. That was a wonderful win for him. Garbe fought in November a couple of years ago, and he knocked out Saul Montana, so this guy can fight. And I mentioned the amount of amateur fights he had, well over 300, almost 400 amateur fights in Cuba in the early 90s. He's 32 years old as Garbe in the black trunks. His middle doesn't look that solid, and Barnes looks more trim than when we saw him a month ago.
Well, you know, after you put any type of a belt around your waist, you should be 20% better in your next fight as far as how you sculpt it, how you've taken your training. And Jermell Barnes has that look. He's taking his boxing even more seriously now off the big win against Daniels. And that middle for Garbe, testament to that layoff.
Garbe is, when I saw him as an amateur fighter years ago, he was a very technical guy, a good counterpuncher. Never particularly aggressive, you know, but it's hard to determine that. You do a lot of amateur fights still, David, and it's hard to determine the way they fight as amateurs and as professionals, because the object as amateurs is to touch the guy, and in the professional ranks, it's to hurt the guy. So it's a lot different.
And they're fighting for a computer, trying to please computer scoring, so the touch and go. And we will see that change in the upcoming years with some body punching. But for Garbe, yes, that is his style. And you have to wait to see what he is as a pro to see how aggressive he is.
Looping right hand as Barnes. He has got to remember against this guy that Garbe, in spite of the fact he's been off for a couple of years, this guy has tremendous experience in international competition. So when you throw a right hand, you can't turn your body and walk away, because this guy will jump right on you. You can't make the mistakes that you can get away with a less experienced fighter. Garbe, while he, as a professional, is 16-3 and has been off for the time that I mentioned, this guy still knows his way around a boxing ring.
And for Barnes, that is true from here on out with his career, because his fights will get tougher now that he has that belt. Here comes Garbe. Barnes has been dropping his left hand.
Side of 18 seconds to go, and this is the first round, and it's a pretty good first round. Both guys landing at different times here. Round number one coming to a close. Plenty of action. Jermell Barnes and Ramon Garbe. Well, again, Barnes is a cruiserweight under the 200 pounds, and Garbe 6 pounds heavier, 7 pounds heavier as a heavyweight. Therefore, Garbe, no matter what he does in this fight, can't win. But he can certainly win in the minds of the fellows that do the matchmaking and the head of boxing operations, Jesse Robinson. If Garbe is successful, we'll see more of him, that's for sure. Jermell Barnes came down here more or less as an opponent for Robert Daniels a month ago and lifted the NABO Cruiserweight Championship.
So this is his parlay fight, as he has the belt and now has a potential road to make some noise, because he's got dates and television lined up. Now all he has to do is keep winning.
He needs to jab his way in a little bit more, does Barnes. He wants to slug with this guy, and it's not a good idea to slug with him early.
Well, you know, and he's been dropping his left hand on the way in, and he's paying for it.
Now, he got clipped pretty good by Ramon that time. Here's Ramon loading up wide shots underneath the elbows of Barnes, and Barnes having a little bit of difficulty with Ramon Garbe at this particular juncture, but we're only in the second round of a scheduled 12-round affair.
Barnes even waving Garbe in, a little bit of a macho move, and he needs to fight with the same hunger and desperation he had in the last fight and go back to his technical tools.
Now let's hear from Darnell Giles in the corner of Jermell Barnes. How's it going there, Darnell?
Right now, he's just taking his time, just trying to wear him down a little bit. But he should be all right going into the later rounds. But right now, he just needed to move a little bit more and just be first.
Doesn't seem like he's getting that jab off to hold him off either.
Okay. Right now, you know, like I said, you know, he just got to move his hands a little bit more, but I'm quite sure he'll be all right. We got to move.
All right, we'll see how it goes. Thanks for the comments. And right now it's Garbe trying to keep the pressure on Jermell Barnes. That, of course, Carnell Giles is Barnes' corner man.
I think they may try to work on the body more and try to tap into what they would perceive as a stamina problem down the stretch for Garbay. And if he can get in tight and smother Garbay, he can work that body and not pay for it as he's been on the outside taking the big shots.
Well, I like the way he came in with the jab throwing there against a guy with this kind of experience. And now that time he loaded up the right hand. That's all right if you're coming in throwing. But you don't want to just walk in against a guy with the kind of experience and noticeable power that Garbay has shown so far. Nice sneaky right hand that time by Barnes. Here comes the bell to end the second round. Garbay certainly won the first minute and a half of that. There's no question. We'll see how the judges saw the second half. But based on that, you almost have to give Garbay that round.
It's a good round for Garbay, but the second half of it was a good investment in body punching by Jermell Barnes, whether he wins the round or not. Well, as they go to work on the inside, Barnes tries to get in. Garbay with two jabs. Good solid right hand by Garbay. And he sneaks a shot in on Barnes. And a good round.
Let's keep it clean, guys. Let's keep it clean.
This is scheduled for 12 rounds of championship distance. The judges are Peter Tremetera, Michael Pernick, and Gary Ritter off from the state of Florida. All right. In the black trunks is Ramon Garbay, and in the blue trunks, the truth, Jermell Barnes, a school teacher from Rochester, New York, spending a lot more time training since his victory over Robert Daniels a month ago.
Right! Good, step back.
Remember, Barnes defeated the former WBA Cruiserweight title holder when he defeated Robert Daniels.
That was a big win. He derailed any hopes that Daniels had for mounting something, and he came down here unheralded, came out with a big win, and this is his run now. This is his chance to follow up and try to run the table a little bit.
He's not your typical boxer, if there's such a thing, because they're all individuals, but I mean, this guy's a college-educated kid, school teacher, professional, very bright guy, in and out of the ring, very pleasant to talk to and visit with us. We've had the opportunity for a couple of months now to get to know this guy. And he's performing much better in this round, Dave, in terms of his boxing.
And it's always tough for guys who have a job outside of boxing to do well in boxing because of the demands and the sacrifices required. And so he's a refreshing story. And nothing will come easy for him. He's working the body well this round. I think that's a good move for him. It's how he beat Daniels. Stay away from power shots.
In the middle of all that, as he was landing some nice body blows, Garbay loaded up a left hook and caught him. So the fact of the matter is Barnes is in terrific shape because he gobbled it up and didn't even buckle his legs.
Before that extra 10% came in.
That's right.
Talked about his better condition.
Yeah, he was very honest with us a month ago. What did he say? It was 80% or
85% a month ago, right. Up to 95 now.
And his body does look a lot more cut now. But as you said, when you put that championship belt around your middle, that has something to do with not only your midsection, but also with your thinking and your attitude in the ring.
It really does. You carry yourself like you expect to win, and that sooner or later you'll find a way to win. And that the points of this fight, it would be hoping that Garbay wears down because of the layoff.
He asked Barnes if his championship intimidates the kids in his school, and he said, oh, yeah, I can't. Time. This is round three of scheduled for 12 rounds. And you know, it's obvious what the philosophy is of Jermell. You just try to wear this big guy down. They've been out of action for a while.
And he's doing it much better in this round, and you see the combinations that come with it.
Now, that's a nice boxing round for Barnes. If Garbay won the last round, Barnes certainly came back to win this one. I get this fight dead
I'm
even.
A minute, I'm on minute. Minute.
Here we go, round number four from the Seminole Casino at Coconut Creek. You're watching Warriors Boxing across the nation and around the world. I'm Bob Sheridan, with me Dave Von Tempo and Mark Goldberg. Glad that you can be with us wherever you are watching. The principal's in there. In blue is Jermell Barnes from Rochester, New York, 16-3. He's the reigning NABO Cruiserweight champ. He's taking on Ramon Garbay, a very experienced amateur fighter with a record of 387 victories in Cuba before he came to the United States. plates and a 16-3 record as a professional. At the very top, as we see the warning of the low blow by referee Jorge Alonso. We told you that Garbay cannot win the title because he weighed in at 206 pounds. The limit for the cruiserweight division is 200 pounds, and that's up from 195 in recent months. So Garbay didn't make the weight, so he cannot win the title.
The cruiserweight is the only division that's moved up in weight itself. It started at 190 and then 195 and now at 200. And Garbay is actually larger than Muhammad Ali was in some fights.
And I like that by the brain trusters at Boxing World, because Dave, the heavyweights today, the big guys are all in excess of 20, 30, the huge, the heavyweights. The real successful ones, you know what I mean?
We've seen guys 195 struggle in that heavyweight division because they're giving away 50 pounds. So, you know, you have a chance to stay down there.
Of course, a good friend of the Seminole Indians by the name of Roy Jones Jr. might take exception to that, because this is a guy that had to put weight on to come up and then go back down to 175. And the big question is, what is he going to do?
I don't think he will ever do that again. Going down in weight, that's a lot of strength.
Shot landed that time. Barnes, a terrific physical condition. Parring shot to the body by Garbay. You hear Jorge Alonso concerned about the heads. Nice uppercut inside by Barnes, Dave.
Good ebb and flow here, a chess match, as Garbay is trying to get a home on the inside now, realizing that Barnes was, and they're hoping to position themselves. And this is, hey, win seven rounds. That's how these guys approach it. You know, you don't have a good round, come back the next round. Set up at a different place. We're seeing these guys trying to fight. Right now it's an inside game.
Two nice uppercuts in a row by Ramon. And Barnes doesn't want to let this round slip away, because, you know, the first round was almost too close to score. I think the judges will have that split and how they scored that. The second round, you know, Garbay won the first half of it. I thought that Barnes outboxed Garbay throughout the third round. And this is another one of those seesaw rounds that could go either way. Uppercut, followed by the chopping right hand again by Garbay. Garbay just might steal the ground.
That's a nice flourish to try to impress the judges at the end.
And a cracking right hand in the ear is the belt. Garbay finished pretty well. If Barnes' idea of getting the hand in there and throwing the leg down, it's working well, but he's one way or the other. He's right where he wants to be at the stage, but I wouldn't take any more head blows like he took there in that round.
And here came Garbay, putting on a lot of pressure at the end. And there is an excellent uppercut that a chopping right hand that Garbay able to put on in the last 20 seconds of the round. And these were definitive, because they probably took the round for him as he came on and had an unanswered sequence at the end of the round. That usually scores very well in the eyes of the judges.
All right, we're set to move to round number five.
What's the water there?
This is the cruiserweight division, which is a 200-pound limit. And we mentioned on a couple of occasions how Garbay came in at 206. Jermell Barnes in at 199. By the way, should Garbay win this fight, Barnes doesn't get to keep his title, but he gets to fight for it again, because this guy is a heavyweight.
So Barnes is literally looking at a double elimination tournament for his own title, because he can't. He wins one of the next two fights for it, he's got it. Of course, yep. He would like to make it easy by winning the one tonight, but he's not in a bad situation here.
He's in an excellent situation. He's also got a guy that hasn't been in the ring in a couple of years, into the fifth round now in a scheduled 12-round affair, and a guy that fought most of his career in three-round fights with two-minute rounds.
And you know you're going to get a guy in rounds 9, 10, 11, 12. If a guy starts to fade, you've got him. You came off a 12th round to yourself just a month ago. So for Barnes, later is better. And that's how he's been approaching this fight. That's the dangerous punch.
And the 16 victories for Garbay, he's got 13 knockouts. For Barnes, and his 16 wins, has only 4 knockouts. So he doesn't have the heavy punch. The statistics tell the story there. The way Barnes comes in like that, Dave. He's not throwing the jab, he just comes in with his hands up beside his head. I'd like to see him punch his way in when he gets in.
We've seen him do that sometimes in his fighting. When he's been able to get the jab going, he has fired a good right hand behind him. When you don't fire the jab coming in, you get caught And sometimes he's been dropping that left hand when he's been coming in, and that's also when he's been caught.
Come on, no holding,
also, sometimes when he's coming back out, he gets lazy, drops the left arm, and he's wide open for a counter right hand. And Garbe, yeah, there it is right there. I mean, a chopping right hand, because Barnes is not punching his way in.
And the right eye of Barnes starting to swell. So keep an eye on that during this fight. He has the beginning of a problem now, and that could be a big problem.
Barnes realizes he's got a lot of pressure on him. He's up on his toes a little bit, trying to move around, and he should use more movement with Garbe, because Garbe has got that body style, and he's got more of a plotting fighter to begin with.
And yet he should be moving to his left and stay out of the power range of Garbe's left hand so that Garbe can make that eye burst on Barnes. At the same time while that's happening, Garbe looking a little winded, so opportunity staring both guys in the face.
Right hand lead, the hand speed again of Garbe. Garbe certainly out hustled Barnes in this one.
Good round for him.
Right, the bell ends the fifth. And I gave Garbe the second. I had the first one too close to call. So on my scorecard, Barnes has only won one round. And that was the third round.
I gave him the first, which was just close enough to get the whisper. So I had Garbe by a one point. And you know, the judges probably split that round. Well, Barnes does get some opportunities in the last round. Gets an uppercut nicely thrown from in close. Perfect positioning, not too far away, then shoves off Garbe, who is strong, and you get a look at that eye.
That is a real problem, Dave, you're right. Got the end swell on it, but that thing's closing up pretty good.
That will be the story of this fight. It's getting worse by the moment.
Well, and part of the reason for that, Dave, is back to what we said in the very first round of the fight, that he wasn't jabbing his way in, so he's wide open for the left hooks of Garbe, and while Garbe hasn't been able to shift him, I mean, he's certainly taking his reach away to the right side of the body.
It closed up in a hurry.
Yeah.
It really did. It really just began to materialize semi-seriously last round, and now he is staring at a major obstacle, and he has to try to unleash it, and with only four knockouts, it's a terrible place to be in a fight.
Meanwhile, Garbe wants to land as many shots as he can right back on top of that eye and try to end this fight. And it's a real problem. I don't think Barnes can see through all the right side.
And the left hand will come pulling through. You saw it right there. This corner will have to take a good look at this and decide whether he should try to fight another day.
The eye is just, I mean, almost closed right up. Garbe realizes it. He cracks him again. Uppercut. Wants to land the left hook. Now what he should be doing is taking a little shuffle step off that right shoulder of Barnes and getting around to his own left and Barnes' right and try to keep cracking that eye.
Anything that he throws, whether a jab, a hook, anything that just rubs against that eye will do major damage.
See, Barnes being the boxer, I mean, what he's doing is fine, but I mean, without any vision, and the unlikelihood that he could knock out Garbe, because Garbe still seems strong. It's only the sixth round of a scheduled 12-round fight. I can't possibly see how that eye can hold up the rest of the fight.
No, especially when you look at what's happened in just one round's time.
All right, watch your head, Barnes.
Yeah, Barnes is coming out. I don't even think he sees his head. Did you hear the referee, Jorge Alonso, say, watch your head?
And they will check that. Even more so between rounds, and he'll have to pass a test every round with the doctors.
Bring him up, Barnes. Bring him up.
Right there with the uppercut. Now he's got the forearm, and you'll see referee Alonso say, hey, no to that forearm in the chin area. Boy, Garbe is really, I'll tell you one thing, he doesn't look like he's in great shape. He's doing a lot of fighting for 3 minutes of every round through six rounds.
And he's doing enough that he's got this fight where he can win it.
Well, he certainly can. He's really got things going his way right now. Because, again, I only have Barnes winning the third round as the sixth round is in the books. And that's a Garbe round. It might score count at least. And you'll see the doctor, as David said, come up and check him out again. Only the referee can stop the play, but I've never seen the referee in the advice position.
Okay, how many fingers do I have?
Three.
Three? Mm-hmm. Can you protect yourself?
Yes, sir.
You are good.
Okay, let's go.
All right, he's going to let him go another round.
And it's
stop, Bucks!
In that wild card state, some states they'd stop that. In this particular case, they let him go.
Well, of course, the physicians and referees and all the officials in the state of Florida, where it's a fairly active boxing state, you know, they're used to boxing injuries. You go to a state where they're not used to a lot of boxing, and they would stop this fight already, Dave.
Right, and you're in the gray area where you couldn't blame the doctor if he stopped the fight there. So you're, as a fighter, you're in a tough spot. You're living on borrowed time in this fight. You have to unleash desperation now, because it's not going to go 12 based on the history of situations like this.
But, you know, in Barnes' case, he's a bright guy, smart guy. He has nothing to lose, really, because he's going to get another shot at this NABO title. He'll lose the title until his next fight, which would probably be in a month. And for him to take any serious damage to that eye is not the brightest thing that you can do for a smart guy. But fighters are a different breed of people, Dave. We've been around them our whole lives. These guys are competitors, and there's no quitting most of them, especially when they get to the level where this guy's an NABO champion.
Where
it is a lesser championship, he's still a champ.
And, you know, in some sports, you say, okay, you've got two fights to win one. You know, we lose one, it's okay, but a fighter hates to walk out of the ring in front of a crowd thinking that he left something on the table still to do. So Barnes has to try and fight as if believing this fight would not be allowed to go the whole way.
Well, for Barnes, his boxing ability is just not helping him right now because of the eye problem. And Garbe apparently is not wearing down, because we're in the seventh round. Granted, it's scheduled for 12, but Barnes isn't winning any rounds.
No. Down at least two and maybe four based on how the judges saw the first round. And so he could be in a position pretty soon of having to sweep the cards to get the win.
Well, you've got a two, I've got a three in there. Some judges, you said, could have it four rounds separating these fighters after six. I mean, we're in the seventh round here.
If you gave Garbe the first round, then he's up by four. Question is, will Garbe take advantage of what's sitting in front of him? This round, he's not going after the vulnerable area as much as he did in the last round.
Barnes not doing a particularly good job of boxing him. He's doing all he can do, but he's not doing anything really to take this round either. And Garbe has landed a heavier blow, so I mean, I got to give him this round as well. I got all the admiration of the world for Barnes, but I can't give him this round. He's up with his toes down, trying to show some movement, but that's the way he should be boxing this guy to begin with, as the bell ends the seventh round. But he didn't do enough in that round, in my opinion, to win it. And I love it, kid. All right, we're in the eighth round. At the Seminole Casino at Coconut Creek. I'm Bob Sheridan with you, Dave Bontempo, and Mark Goldberg. The principal's in there for the NABO Cruiserweight Championship. Jamel Barnes and Ramon Garbe. Garbe having things pretty much his way to this point. Garbe stuck his hand out, wanted to touch gloves, and Barnes wanted no part of it there.
And I don't think it was a sportsmanship thing. I think he was just in a rhythm where he wanted to jab, and he didn't want to get out of that rhythm, because he didn't do it with any type of a medicine.
No. He's not that kind of guy anyway.
No, but the crowd reacted as if there was some bad sportsmanship, but he didn't want to get into a different technique.
Well, here's Barnes trying to go to work on Garbe. Garbe punches a piston-like jab in the face of Barnes. And Barnes on it.
Garbe is going to work on the eye in this round. He's landed three shots in that area already.
Now, Barnes has got to get that jab going, and he hasn't established that jab during the course of this fight whatsoever. As I say that, he gets a couple out there, but he's not working off it, Dave. He's not throwing the right hand behind him. He's not coming in. He's not getting in and back out again. Not doing the circling and not up on his toes. I mean, this guy, we saw him against Daniels a month ago. He was a terrific boxer in that fight.
What, you get overpowered a little bit by a stronger guy, and it takes away some of the sureness in your movement. Watch what's happened to him.
Coupled with the bad eye, and he's got some serious problems.
Watch your
head. And on my scorecard, I've only got him winning one round in the, well, we're into the eighth round now, so through seven, I've only got him winning one round. Judges may have that slightly different, but the idea is that he's not doing a great job at this fight of boxing.
And if you're in his corner and you don't believe he's got a chance on the scorecards, you don't let him try to gut out the rest of this fight. You throw in the towel and come back for another day so that it doesn't sustain the damage that would prevent him from coming back. So,
well, I would have been thinking about that around or so ago, but you know, as we talked about, fighters are a different breed. They don't want that corner stopping the end of the fight.
As the rounds pile up, sometimes the corners just have to become unpopular with their fighters and make a move like that. It's a tough one to do.
Not even Rocky would let Mickey do anything but slip that.
Told him to open it up.
Here's Bounds opening up a little bit. Loads up the right hand and whistles past the nose of Jarbe. Seconds of the eighth round now.
Yeah.
Oh, that was a better round for Barnes, by the way.
In a spot in the fight now, Colonel, where if he's going to get to Garbe slowed down, it will happen now. And toward the end of the last round, Barnes coming on the inside. Good movement, good five-punch combination, and we haven't seen this from him throughout the fight.
Let's see
Jermell Barnes working downstairs, taking one upstairs, but
can you still see?
He got himself into another level of intensity. Now we'll see if it carries over.
Well, that's what he has to do. Here we go to round number nine. This is for the NABO Cruiserweight Championship and the WBC Continental America's Cruiserweight Championship. It's Garbe in the black trunks with the white trim, Barnes in the blue trunks with the black trim. Barnes has had problems going way back to the fourth and into the fifth round where the right eye became a real problem. Garbe has tried to take advantage of it at times. Barnes had a pretty good eighth round. He gets him back into the fight, especially if he gets in the ninth round with three to go.
He's at the point of the fight where if he gets the Garbe retreat, he can come on and get this on points. This is what his plan was.
Well, it looks like he has some sort of second win right now. But this is bad now. He should slide down the ropes and get out of it. Don't take these shots, because he can't afford to allow him to whack him below the elbow and then come back upstairs with a left hook on top of that eye again.
Especially now that you've got some momentum off the last round and coming out strong here in the beginning of this round.
Hey, why hasn't Garbe just gone all out there with left hooks? I mean, three, four, five left hooks in a row.
We saw it three rounds ago, then he took a round off and a little bit last round. You have to wonder about that absence of killer instinct, because he had the victory sitting right there at the end of his jab. Just go after the eye the entire time, close it up. You can't let the guy get back into the fight that way, and he's tired now.
Yeah, he is fatigued now. I mean, after all, this guy hasn't fought in a couple of years, and his first fight back, he comes into a 12-round affair for a title.
And this is where Barnes had figured he would surge past Garbe and win the fight, and if he's going to do it, he's going to do it with one eye.
I mean, the record of Garbe, the 16-3, is why he's getting the shot. As there weren't any other guys available. Jesse Robinson jumped right on that opportunity and got him in against Barnes. And he's trying to take advantage of it. Barnes doing a nice job of boxing now.
And a lot of guts by Barnes with what he's been able to overcome with the eye problem. Yeah, a lot of times you can't see out of the one eye, but every left hand hits you. And here he's digging in and he's fighting aggressively with the one eye.
Here's Garbe in a fairly close round taking it back though. So Garbe has got some heart to him.
And if Garbe wins this round, that will be a pivotal exchange, which you just saw. Because he only needs a round maybe to put himself in a good spot.
Well, with just a few seconds to go in the ninth round, this is still up for grabs the way I see it. I don't know if Barnes is enough to win this round. He boxed pretty good in the early going. Maybe he did. I don't know. But if he did, It's a two-point fight with three rounds to go.
Well, it smells like 10-10.
Yeah.
And that doesn't work for Barnes.
Well, folks, if they scored the last round even, or the judges flip-flopped on how they scored that round, it could be a three-round fight with three rounds to go. But it's most important for Jermell Barnes to win this round. The last one was urgent. This one is almost an absolute necessity if he's going to have any shot at winning this fight. Remember, Barnes is the guy in the blue trunks with the black trim with his back here right now. And Ramon Garbay, the slug-hammering big guy who came in at 206 pounds, can win the fight but can't win the championship. Should he win?
Yeah, should he win the fight and not get the championship, he would be moaning with 6 pounds and he wouldn't cost him.
But you know something, considering the way this fight went and with the eye problem of Barnes, and Barnes has the fight for the title again, who knows, they might bring Garbay back and give him a shot at the title again.
There are all possible scenarios in this.
Well, Warriors Boxing, they're going just about every month now. It's good for these fighters that have signed with Warriors. And Jesse Robinson, they put on a good show, get him right back in action again. There's the left hook by Barnes this time. Nice chopping right hand.
Come on, come on. Let's go.
On top of the left eye this time.
But we haven't seen Garbay go enough with that left hand to the vulnerable area. At times we've seen him do it, but it should have become a permanent part of his attack. And Barnes has fought with a ton of heart.
Yeah, he has.
With what's happened to him in this fight.
He has, but there's no sense of urgency in this round for him. I mean, he's not really, really hustling that much. Of course, there's a fatigue factor for him too, don't forget. I mean, he's a guy that came out and fought 12 rounds last time. He's back with a much heavier puncher. I mean, that's not doing anything, those little tap-tap, shoe-shine shots of the midsection.
But we came out and we saw him fight with a lot of confidence in the first couple of rounds and a carryover from the last bout. And then Garbay hit him with some power shots. And we've seen Barnes fight a technician's type of a fight now with only some sporadic attempts at offense. And although he's been gutsy, he hasn't been consistent with his strategy.
A little bit of a knot on the high right cheekbone of Garbay, but that's really insignificant right now at this stage of the fight. We're in the 10th round. Remember, this is scheduled for 12, but again, it's Garbay that's landing the heavier blows right now.
And this is supposed to be in the blueprint for Barnes when he's flying past Garbay, and it's not happening.
And here's Garbay trying to put an exclamation point on the fact that he's going to win the 10th round. Barnes up on his toes, but a lack of work, not a lack of will by any means.
That's a huge get though for Garbay. This round is a huge one for him.
As I say that, all the hot desire in the world by Barnes, but Garbay had a terrific round again. Doctor wants to have another look. Dr. Fields is his name.
No damage to the eye at all. Cover his eye.
Okay, that's fine. Cover his eye.
Look at me.
He seems to say it's okay. He's going to let Jermell Barnes continue.
Better now.
Okay, that eye was closed before. It's actually improved for him.
I thought I heard
because
he
wasn't getting hit.
Yes, Dave, I thought I heard the doctor say it's actually better now, too. So the corner, we want to give certainly Nelson Lopez and Nelson Lopez Jr. Credit in the corner of Garbay for keeping him fresh, but Donnell Giles and Stacy McKinley, the guys that work in the corner of Barnes, they're going to do a good job, too.
It's a two-part process. One, the corner has to come in with the devices, in this case, the entry. Right. But two, the fighter has to make sure he doesn't get hit there too often and give that a chance to apply. And against the odds, Jermell Barnes able to do that in this fight.
Well, both guys are going to want to win this round. Certainly on our scorecard,
bring a punch yourself,
Barnes needs it much more than Garbay does. But nice uppercut by Garbay. Follow with the right hand. You know, I tell you this, Dave, you know, I talked about, you know, most of his fights, close to 400 amateur fights, but I tell you, he's a slick fighter as a professional, too.
Hey, and if you come off a long layoff and then come up with a good performance and win a fight like that, you have to, A, kick yourself about the layoff, and then, B, try to jumpstart your career and get active because there's a lot of things out there for you, and that's how Ramon Garbay can be looking at this.
He's also going to give himself a boot because to lose 6 pounds for a guy that weighs 200 pounds is not a lot of effort.
Right.
You're talking, you could do that in a couple of days, but not knowing where you stand and where your weight is coming to a weigh-in, is ridiculous for a professional, especially when you get a shot at a title. But he certainly performed admirably, just his business ethic coming to the fight.
Against the odds in another way. Guys who are overweight, usually they turn in an uninspired performance, but Garbe has waged a good effort in this bout, and he's on his way to winning it.
Yeah, he has, and the fact that he's as strong as he is, mind you, there's plenty of fatigue by both guys at the stage of the fight, as well as should be if they're working very hard through 10 rounds of boxing and now into the 11th round, the closing minute of the 11th round.
I think Barnes put himself in a position almost where we had to sweep these last four rounds, and already Garbe has one of them. And so,
I mean,
it distorts his effort.
Barnes is touching him up all right. He's doing some nice boxing, Dave. But at this stage, he needs to crack him with some shots because he's not going to win by trying to outbox him now. Garbe has landed the heavier blows, and I think he's done more damage in this round. Now, different judges see it different ways, you know. I just happen to think that in the professional ranks, when you land the heavier blows, such as the Mosley De La Hoya fight, I think it's a perfect example where Mosley landed the heavier blows. He staggered De La Hoya on a couple of occasions, and, you know, I don't think there was any controversy as far as I'm concerned. I think
And if you're not a big puncher, you have to act like you should win 9 rounds out of the 12 because you don't want to leave any doubt.
Both guys still going at it at the end of the 11th round. But the crowd here at Coconut Creek likes what they're seeing. This is a good fight. Here we go, round number 12. The 12th and final round, the NABO Cruiserweight Championship on the line.
For Garbe, you know, if you're in a different division and you go up 6 pounds, it may make a big difference physically in how you fight. But in this case, you can't say the 6 pounds really helped him that much. It's in a division that's full of big guys anyway. It's not that big a deal. And for that big a deal, he does.
Well, I guarantee you after this workout that he's dropped to 6 pounds, he's probably under the 200 pounds right now. And that's unfortunate. Because he came in here maybe at 206, or maybe after weighing in, he could have been 212, who knows. But if he came in at 206 legit, he would be under that going out. So. But that isn't the way it works in boxing. You gotta make the weight at the weigh-in, the day before. As you know, Dave, and many of you may or may not know that I'm watching years ago, they waited the day of the fight to change that life for the media, to get a little media hype.
Right, get those numbers going.
In this day and age, a guy can weigh in at 200 pounds yesterday and fight at 230 if he can put that much weight on. But certainly they can put on his big guys can put on 7-10 pounds.
We saw that in the last Roy Jones fight.
Yeah.
Each guy put up each guy came in a weight class higher the day later.
Right. This is the 12th round. Jermell Barnes has had fits because he had an eye problem going back to the 4th round. It became a major problem where the doctor had to check it out. And the 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th round. Worked hard, but Jermell Barnes just hasn't been able to land the shots that Garbe has landed throughout the course of the fight. And both of them are fatigued now, just trying to get through this final little over a minute to go in the fight.
We talked about Jermell Barnes trying to make a run for this. You know, when you're not a puncher, you have to wage just about a perfect fight every time. And the stakes are higher for Jermell Barnes now. He's in these title bouts. And there's no margin for error when you're not a puncher.
Well, one thing, if he has to get back and fight Garbe in another month or so when the eye heals up, he's going to realize that by watching the footage of this fight and realize what the mistakes he made. And the strategy, I think, going in was sound, but Garbe never really wilted that much during the course of the fight.
If the guy's going to wilt, you have to do enough during those first 8 rounds to make him wilt. And Barnes unable to do that. Garbe's strong.
Yeah, and Barnes is just trading shots right now. And every time you trade with a stronger puncher, you're getting the worst of it. That's what's happening right now at this stage of the fight with just 20 seconds to go. An entertaining fight, but it's not a good night for Barnes. All right, this fight is just about in the books. A good effort at the end for Barnes, and even to be given that round, I don't think it's going to be enough.
Because the two close fights, I gave him